The video I started now. Sorry, I forgot to start recording. Actually, normally those people who invite me, they take care of that. Okay. So I have created my Naveen, it's saying he has created the account. Good. Okay. I hope, but let me do one thing. Let me save this chat so far. Save as and okay, your attendance for the morning is safe now, and this session we are doing the recording. I'm sorry, I forgot it, but anyway, could you enroll user to my course? I could enroll user to my course, but how they are going to be invited? Okay, what you need to do, let me show it to you by doing that, but just wait. Go to YouTube and search that video which you want to use for your course, but please remember that all the videos may not be reusable, because by default the YouTube videos are copyright protected, but giving the URL or embedding them may not be a problem. So here is the share button. You need to go at just at below the video share button, and that same thing will apply to Vimeo. On the Vimeo also you do the same thing, and here you see the URL which I just pasted in the chat box, and here is the embed code. You need to come to the embed code. And most of the videos, if they play, including on Facebook and other areas, you will find their embedding code. So embedding code is the embedding means it will be displayed there only. The difference between URL and embed is that embed to display it. Okay, I hope you see it now. Okay, thank you. Last time I showed you how to add a video. Did you watch it? How to add a video? Just say yes for video. Okay, now how to invite the students for your course? Simple. You need to tell them three things. You go to your course, and the process will remain the same. Either here, if you are in Genomeo, the best thing is that you can go to your, this is your site name. Up till this one is your site name. So you copy it and then say like paste it in the chat there, and let them know their username and password. So that way you need to tell them three things. For example, here this is the page, this is the course. If you click on the course, it will show you this course URL. Okay, so this is the course URL, and let me, yesterday I don't know, I forgot the name. I had sent a password for test student via WhatsApp.
Hello, sir, can I interrupt?
Yes.
Sir, we can simply go to participants. If they have enrolled the users, then we can go to participant and then select all of them. Send they ask, what do you want to do with the selected thing? We send a message saying that this is your user ID and this is your password, and send that message. The message goes to all the participants. And they get to know what is there. They can open the link also, and they, by using the username and the password, they can go to the course. That's what I have been doing.
Yeah. That way, it is here the participants. You can select them, but if they are need to be added separately, then you can use it. So here is the participants banner. And you see here are the names, and you can select all of them or some selected people, And then with what them you are to want to do, you can send them a message and other things like here the enrollment methods. You can allow them for self-enrollment. And when you click on send a message or a new note, then here the message will come and you type them thanks and the message, send the message, and it will go to their registered email ID with whatever. What will happen once we added them as users and then enrolled them? Okay, the first thing is you have to add them as users. The users means they are now in your database. And from your database, then you need to take them to your course. That is the difference. And then they will have access to your course from that. So that is easy. Okay, so this is now how you add the resources in your course. Let's have a look on now what are various activities which you can create. Suppose there you want to create a discussion forum. So you click on forum and then click on add. These things, they are similar and work on the same way. Here you can say Corona, any name which you want to give. You can explain the purpose of this forum. And then you can say if you want them that they can attach something. So you can define that. How many numbers they attachment, say you just allow them to attach only one. This is very good for of your any exploratory kind of activity, that they can, you can give them some question and then all will be working on that. But be careful that if you use it as an assignment activity, you can use it as an assignment activity, but here all the answers will be visible to everyone. Say like simpler, this has come, add a new discussion topic. From my side, I will say that what do you suggest are the safety measures, and then you can think, and here please suggest two ways, like that, and then save it, post to the forum. It will post it and it will allow you that if you want to make any changes into it within 30 minutes. After that, you won't be able to edit it. So here is the forum, and there is at present no reply, but some of you, if those who have that ID with test user, you can go in there and then you can reply to that. So this way it will look like. So here is the discussion, and you click on that discussion and you can see the message, please say. And here with the help of reply, you can say one measure is this, second measure is this, and submit. So this way it has become threaded. You see, the first one is little to the right. So that way it will show you thread, that it wants what sequence it is progressing from that side. So that is the, and it can be used as a good assessment activity. It is called as the peer assessment. Here you can make it as peer assessment in the sense that you can make a declaration announcement that everybody will reply to the answer given by others and then rate them. So you can give A, B, C, D, E the rating to the answer of other colleagues. So everybody reviews the answers of everyone. And from there, you can, you know, make them an activity that how it is being conducted. Another one, assignment. It's a the normal kind of assignment which you want to give to your students. Shushma is asking, how are the participants notified about a new discussion point that has been added to the module? in the discussion forum like just I did, as soon as you make it and those students who are in that discussion class, a notification and email will go to them. That I have been using. And when Dr. Sadhana makes some statement, you get it an email from there. So an email goes to your students. You need not worry about it. Now here is the assignment.
So I think announcement automatically goes to the students also. If
yes.
you announce anything,
yes.
it goes to students.
The difference between the announcement and discussion forum is that in the announcement, it is one-sided. It is the announcement by the teacher. And it goes compulsorily
to
everyone.
Yeah, discussion forum is both ways.
Yes, and the discussion forum is both ways. So there, it is interaction actually. That is announcement. I'm announcing something. And here it is discussion forum. Means I want your opinion also. So you can reply to that. And then there are settings in that discussion forum that whether you want it to be forced subscription to everyone or optional. If I make it forced subscription, then you will definitely receive all the messages at any point when someone does something, you will be. And sometimes it becomes flooded, like in a conference. If there is everybody is typing something, you keep on adding, receiving email, and then so. And in that case, you can make it optional. Students want, they can resist. But it, as a teacher point of view, if you are using it as a class, it is better to make it forced subscription. Let them receive. Savitaji is asking in the forum answers are visible to student, same with the assignment. No, that's what I'm going to show it to you now. Only discussion forum is visible to everyone, whatever they say, not the assignments. So this is the assignment now, the actual assignment which you give as a homework, as the examination to your students. So again, we are taking this common theme as Corona. And here's the description if you want the what do you want them? So, okay. Explain in about 300 words what are the symptoms of coronavirus. That is your statement. Upload your assignment before April 26th 2020. You can upload Word or PDF, etc., whatever, or image, the instructions, normal instructions, and you can make it appear on the web page. And here you can upload additional files related to that. Say, for example, there I put the question only, but it has long instructions. There is no need for you to type them. You can just simply upload that detailed file. Can we set a time limit for submission? Just wait, I'm coming to that. Now, that is what who asked me this question. Dr. Samita Bhatia asked that question, which you can see in your chat box now. That is there. I want this assignment now, either as a homework or as a terminal examination, means where you will see that, see how it is to be done. Now suppose today is 23rd and it is going to be 3 o'clock. So here I will make it 3 means 15 and I will change it to 23rd April and it will close at 5 o'clock there. And this will be available now only within this period. After that, you won't be able to upload anything. No. Then how the students will submit it? You can make them to submit type online, but if it involves some diagram or something, it's better to allow file submission. And if file submission, how many files they can upload? You can 20 up to 20, but you can restrict them, and the maximum size and the accepted file size, whatever. If you fix here some PDF, only PDF, doc, only doc, like that. That is for the students to submit. Now comes the feedback type. As a teacher, how you will be providing feedback? Feedback comments or feedback file? Feedback file means their MS Word document which they uploaded. You download them, read them, make them comments by review, track changes, and upload it back. Or you can use yes online comments. You make it and the online comments will be visible. Then here is the submission settings. It requires students to click submit. Not necessary. They will just upload it and it is submitted. So these are the things. And this is important for you, grading, because now you will be giving them marks. Maximum marks 100. Out of that, how much you think the student need to have? About 50. And blind marking, this way, that, anything, these are the not the important things. And then you click and save and display. So now see, as a teacher, you will see this. It is not hidden from students. This is the assignment which you have given to them, the, with the instructions. There are three students in this class. No has submitted as of now, because nobody had submitted, so no grading. And that means that all the three needs to be graded, and this assignment is still due, time is remaining. And due date is this one. Means 5 o'clock, after that, due date is over. You won't be able. Now, how do you see them or how do you grade them? You can click on grade or view submission. And when you click on grade, it will open you this box in which you will see the, if they have uploaded the word, that can change it. Here the assignment PDF, otherwise it will show you the attached assignment in this window. Here you can give them the marks out of 100, whatever. And this is here you change the user by clicking on here. At present it is Gajanan in the center. The email ID of the student, the date, the course on the upper left corner. And here you can type your comments. Well done, whatever you want to say. And once you have given the marks after reading them, and if you want your feedback files, the uploaded file by you with your comments there. And once you do that, here you see at the end there is notify students. If you tick mark it, it will immediately, like in this case, the message will go to Gajanan and save changes. So the changes were saved. Okay. And it has gone there. So now if Gajanan can go into his course area, or maybe his email, can check that there will be a message. And you see here is the grade book. You can see it has been graded now, and these are the marks. And in other cases there is no, and still you can see here is the teacher comment which you typed, well done. So the students will be, when they log into their account, they will see it from there. Yeah, it is like Google Classroom, but it is more powerful than Google Classroom. Okay, assignment submitted. So this is how we create an assignment in the course. This is very quite powerful. You can make anything as an assignment and get them loaded into that. So that is assignment. The second is this big blue button. It is something like Zoom, WebEx, which we are using now, Google Meet. This big blue button is open source web conferencing tool. So you, and it is by default in, I think it is not in Genomeo. Here it is in Moodle Cloud. So it is very simple. If you click on Moodle big blue button and add, it will create a class. So here is the class. You can say about, we will discuss about virus. And here is the send notification. If you tick it, the notification will be sent. Send a notification to users enrolled to let them. So click the, there are three students, a notification will go to them. And if you see it here on the top, you will see now it is red one, like on Facebook. I can see it there that there is some notification for me from someone. I can click on it and read that notification what is. And then here I can allow who, either all or someone based on their role, and how those people, they will be performing in that, either as the viewer or as moderator. Moderator means as a teacher in with you. You can have the schedules when it is. At present it is open. As soon as I save it, it will open. Otherwise you can fix a particular date, and on that date the message will go to them, and then they will be joining your class there. So let's say do it, save and display. And I think I left something from there. So then you can continue. And the okay. So here is the our course and our activities areas. Next, there are these two things, the chat and forum. Remember that the discussion forum is mostly asynchronous in nature. Although you can remain present at that time, now we are doing it, we can do it. But by nature, a discussion forum is asynchronous in nature. It means whenever you are doing something, it is not necessary that all the students will react to that. But chat is synchronous in nature. You need to be, it is in real time. We can create a chat session now and we can open it. So maybe if someone can join it, let's create the chat session. And then as a student, the students can enter into it. And again, let us give the name and some instructions here. And then you can have those settings and save and display. So here is the chat ready, as such as, and the web conferencing session will also show you like this. Now it says click here to enter the chat now. So I click on it, and another window has appeared. I'm not sure if you are, do you see a small another window appearing on the screen? Okay, yes, very good. So let me say hello Gajanan ji, and if Dr. Gajanan is there, and if he is in the course, he can type something there, like Dr. Parveen is there in the course, and you can use it talk beep. So the beep, the message sound notification, it will come. This is in real time now, so you can have your question answer. It is something like sometimes ask SRK. Shah Rukh Khan had some, you know, open chat session with his fan followers. It is something like that. In real time you can have it, and it's a good thing to question answer in real time with your students, to have that there. And the accessible interface for those who are special needs children, to make some formattings for them. Then there are few more important interesting things here. One is glossary, and like to conduct a survey, you can use survey. Otherwise we will discuss with quiz. So glossary is again a very powerful tool, and Dr. Sadhana has used it so well in her course because she teaches science. So here what we will do, here is a glossary on viruses. And we will say that all students will add at least one entry into the glossary and blah blah. And is this glossary global? Anyone can see it, means across the courses, and display this on the course page if you want. Okay, make it available, and the entries, their appearance, how they will be, and you click on save and display. After that, say this is the glossary now, and here you can add, you can click. Okay, Dr. Parveen, if you are there, can you just add, make an entry? Or Dr. Gajanan, because this is open now. I'm not muted. My microphone is working. Okay. I'm saying that Dr. Parveen or Dr. Gajanan, if you hear me, can you make an entry into this glossary, so that our colleagues can see that how the glossary will appear? Or perhaps someone who has the test password, they can also add it here. And see, you can have its printer friendly version also. Later on, when the glossary is prepared, you can take a printout, and it will be arranged in this sequence. A special means when you start an entry with zero or something, then followed by A, B, C, D, E, and rest, if there is anything, then that can go there. Okay, so this is about glossary, and we can come back if someone adds to the glossary. So this is the way, and then the important thing is then for your test purposes, creating a quiz. Quiz is very, very important and very powerful function. Okay, they edit as, okay, we will see now. Let's see, let me show you the glossary. Here is the glossary, it will appear like you to the students. And glossary items are very useful for students, as they only use ebooks and not hard copies like us. Okay, so see, here is the glossary, and see, there is one entry here, it shows V because it stands for V, and this is the definition, and here you can hyperlink it, entry link with you can attach it. And as a teacher, you can, you know, decide upon, because you have the authority. If someone types something wrong or etc., you can edit that. But till then, the others, every one of you, you can access it. So that way. And if you remember it, that here is the navigation. You can go from here to the previous session. Like here, you can go back to Corona, or you can have the navigation from here on the top or from the bottom, or you can directly go from jump to a particular section immediately. So the navigation is very easy in Moodle. Anytime you can jump to any place by going there.
Sir, can I ask you a question? Hello?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
When we are making glossary, is it visible to only the teacher or to all students? That's what I didn't ask my students also. I have already done that in my
class. Okay, let me answer you in this way. Let me answer you in this way. Can you all see this glossary here with this entry? If you can see.
Yes, sir.
That's the answer. So the students can see, unless you hide them, make these settings in such a way that auto linking, tag linking, and attachment, you know, you can add something from there. Otherwise, if it is hidden, no, they won't be able to see it. Otherwise, it will be visible. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Now let me show you how to create a quiz. I will add an activity. I will go to quiz. And here is the quiz. Now the quiz offers you a variety of quizzes which you can make. And how? Let's see. Suppose again topic is virus. Here you can see that this quiz has 10 questions. Each has equal marks, blah blah, and like that. Select one and you want to display it here. Now here comes the beautiful thing, timings. If you want to conduct an entrance exam kind of thing, or your final examination kind of thing, make it open and close at a particular time. Say like, if I try to make it open, at present it is taking the current timing, so 23rd April, it is say at present it is showing 5:45. I can means it the opening time it is considering. So if I make it that this quiz will be available from say 4 o'clock till 5 o'clock, and that will be done. Before that and after that, you won't be able to do it. So that is the good feature of it. In Google Quiz, you have to manually stop receiving the responses. But here, software does it. Then time limit. How much time you think that the students can take in attempting this 10 question quiz? Say 20 minutes or 15 minutes, right? So that way. So now there are two kind of restrictions are here. Time, and within that 1 hour or 2 hours or 3 hours, I made it 14 o'clock, it means 2 o'clock. I need to make it 16 hours here. So now from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m., 1 hour duration, but within 1 hour, as soon as you start your quiz, you will get only 15 minutes. Once 15 minutes are over, if you have attempted all the questions, they will be saved. If you have attempted only 8 questions, 8 will be saved, 2 will be left out. Here, this means that open attempts are submitted automatically. If you want to change that, otherwise there is a grace period if you want to give them, or attempts must be submitted before. Then comes the grade, to grade the pass. Suppose this is 10 marks. I want that at least 50% should take, so those who receive at least pass, and how many attempts you allow them. If it is a serious kind of examination, I will give them only one attempt to do it. They won't be able to repeat that. Or if you want them for a practice session, you can make it unlimited. It depends on. And if it is unlimited, then because they are doing it again and again and again, then which is the highest grade, that will be accepted. You can decide it, whatever. The first one, the last one, the average one, it depends on you. But if it is only one, then it goes away, because one means whatever you did it, you earned that. Layout means how the questions will appear. I prefer that if it is a short quiz, say of 10 or 5 questions, you have all the questions on one page. Otherwise, you can have one question on one page, another question on another page, like that. The question behavior. This is very important for you and powerful. Shuffle within the questions. It means yesterday someone was asking about cheating. Okay, I will call. Okay, Dr. Sadhana, what was the answer of question 3? And she will tell me C. Yeah, that way. Here it will reshuffle the questions. And even the options among the questions. So even if she tells me that it is C, on my screen C may be a wrong answer, that way. And the second is deferred feedback. As soon as they attempt it, should they get the feedback or the deferred feedback little later on, you decided by you, that way. So for examination purpose, make it deferred. For practice feedback, you make it immediate feedback. Immediate feedback there. The rest are the simple things. Yeah, and you, when you decide that, you save and display. So here it is, you see, one attempt allowed, this the instruction here, that is the topic, and this closes at 5 o'clock, 5 p.m. And time limit is 15 minutes. Within 15 minutes, we have to do. And at present, there are no questions. We need to add the questions here. For each question, the sequence of yes for everyone. Yes. Otherwise, they will see that question one was, where is Taj Mahal? So everyone will see question one as, where is Taj Mahal? But otherwise, Dr. Samita will see some other question. Punita ji will see some other question. Gajanan will see some other question. If you shuffle it, and it is always better to shuffle those questions. So now you edit the quiz. Yeah, you save the answers. Now we will see that where we are going to save the answers. So here is the page. We have to add our question. See, here is the maximum grade, 10 marks. Because we thought that one question, one mark. So 10 marks out of total. So you can make it 10 and save it. Total number of marks will come there. When we add the questions, then it will change. And here is the shuffling. To shuffle it and add questions. So add a new question, or you can add from a question bank also if you have uploaded your question bank. So a new question, and see, a large variety of questions are available. Calculated, you can see 2 plus 2 what, and calculated multiple choice, calculated simple type, drag and drop into text, drag and drop markers into it, drag and drop onto the image, embedded answer type close, essay type, you can conduct your examination, matching type, multiple choice, numerical, random answer, missing word, short answer, true false, everything you can add it. Let's see, adding a multiple choice. So the multiple choice, so the question name means you can give a name, or you can simply say like do it here. One, or you can, if you want to give the name, then type virus one, whatever it is. MCQ can be graded by the system you answered. Yes, the MCQs. No, descriptive questions are to be evaluated by you, but the MCQs, they will be done by the software. You don't need to you need to tell the software what is the right answer. If you tell there, it will grade it. Now the question is, what is the name of coronavirus of 2019? Okay, and now it is default is 1. I can make it 2, 3, whatever it is. This will be the general feedback about this question at the attempt of this question if you want to say something. And then one answer or many answers, and here it is. Do you want the choice to be reshuffled? So your A, B, C, D, as soon as all the students, they see it on their screens, it will be reshuffled. If you take it here, otherwise it goes. So now, here are my choices. The first is, as you know, the right answer is COVID-19. And this is the right answer. I make it 100%. And then I will say, well done. And here we can write influenza, which is a wrong answer. You can say, write sorry. And then say, fever. And sneezing, whatever, how many you want, you can make it here. And save and continue editing means add more questions, or just for the practice, you go and save changes. And here is the question. You see, now one question has been added, so total marks is 1 has come. You add two questions, here it will become 2 in the total of marks. There, this is the question. This is the one which I typed the name of the here virus and something. So this question is there, and this quiz is closed because at present, let us go back and see how this quiz will look like. I need to make this quiz open. Otherwise, so here is the quiz, and this is the instruction which you gave for your quiz. And as a student, you need to go and okay, let's change the edit settings. And timings and make it open, save and display. So see here it has come. Now let me change my role as a student, and I will become a student, switch role to. So this is what the student will see, attempt quiz now. I will attempt the quiz. It says, since we have given the timing, it says that it has a time limit of 15 minutes. It will count down from the moment you start, and you must submit it before. Are you sure? Yes, I'm sure. So start attempt. And here is the quiz. And here it is showing me the timer and finish attempt. So I will say quiz here. I can, if I think that wrong, I can clear my choice and I can again do it and then finish attempt. So when I finish, it will show me one bar depending on the right, depending on, it is still giving me that it has saved the answer. I can still go back and change it within this time period. But when if I think that it's okay, I'm sure that this answer is correct, I can submit and finish. It is still asking me, are you sure? I said, yes, I'm sure. So this will be the finish. And say if it would have been right answer, it would, this block on the right, it will be green, but here it is red because it is answer is incorrect. The correct answer is this one, and it is showing here. And this is the feedback which has it it displays you. And here it comes the grades, because it was auto graded by the system. So you go to the grades, and whatever the the students they will attempt, this is the quiz, that was the assignment, and the when the student will do it, because this is my account, and it will show you from the teacher point of view the all the marks attained by the students into that. That way the result will be displayed for the students. So that way you create a quiz on the course, and this is very easy. You can export this grade sheet as an Excel sheet. You click on export, and then it asking you what, and you can as a open document or as an Excel sheet, as a plain text file, you can include it and then click on download, and it will be downloaded. Similarly, you can set your grade book. And here are the scales or letters. Depending on your institutional policy, you can make them that how A, B, C, D, etc. they are assigned to the questions or in that way. Okay, so now time for some questions. What are descriptive type questions? The descriptive type questions are essay type questions. Sadhanaji is asking, telling, yes, that is right. The assignment and the descriptive type questions, you have to grade them as a teacher. Then MCQ can be graded by the system is answered. Yes, that is right, advice by Dr. Sadhana. Then what other kind of question can be asked other than MCQ, and how they can be assessed? Oh, just you just saw. There are so many things. You can have true, false, you can have drag, drop, you can have many, a variety of them. Fill in the blanks. Yes, you can create them. Can we make fill in the blank type test? You can. Any feature of grammar check? Okay, this grammar check within this is not possible because Moodle doesn't have that facility, but you can add a feature. Grammarly, an extension to your browser. This is free widget, a plugin which you can add to your web browser. and then whatever work you will do, it will keep on checking in real time, and it will suggest you any spelling mistake, any grammar mistake into it, that you can add it. It's free. It's free. You can just go to this website, Grammarly. Here you can see that it is telling you that it is a free writing app to make their online writing clear and effective. Getting started is simply download the extension today. So you click on there, it is grammar checking for MS Office, etc. And add to Firefox, it is free. If I click on it here, it will go to my web browser and it will be adding there, added there. Okay, can chat session be used for taking Viva students individually? Half of this question or my answer is correct. Yes, you can use a chat session for taking Viva of students, but individually means since the chat session is an open session, so whoever present in that, they can see that chat. If you think that you want only one student, then you can schedule a session in that way that others do not enter into the class. That way you can do it. And there is one more feature of chat, of this chat function. We will show you. You can have a Viva OC, not only typing. You can have a Viva kind of the examination. Match the column we can set. Yes, you can have the match whatever there in the list comes into the quiz. Okay, Swatiji is asking, Savasti is asking, plagiarism and grammar check will have to be done individually. Actually, grammar check here, if you are using it, it automatically done. But for plagiarism, you need to have, if you install it on your university servers, there you need to add Urkund or Turnitin or Authenticate, the extra plugins from there, and then and the software can do the plagiarism check. Now that is automatic in that case. Sushmaji is asking, can you explain how to shift a course from Moodle Cloud to Genomio? Yes, I will do that. I have taken a backup from Moodle, but when I tried import, it is a Genomio, it is showing some issues. Okay, we will do that. Let me close this portion. Okay. Biplabji is asking hot potato for questions. Yes, we can do hot potato, but not here because they don't allow the third party. I'm not sure if you will be able to see my desktop, but I have the hot potato with me. I have given the training on hot potato to people, but really no voice. Induzit saying cannot hear me. Can you say yes if you are hearing me? Okay, good. What I wanted to show you now. Okay, taking a backup. Okay, let's do that. Go to your course area, and here is your course, and you need to be in your course administration from there. So you have the backup, click on the backup. Now it will show you this kind of screen depending on how much material you have added in your course. And it shows you by default what it has selected for you. Say, for example, let me go from the top. Do you want to include in this backup the users which are already enrolled into it? If you say yes, like at it is now, your database may become little heavy according to the number of the students because it is taking that database. If you think that I don't need my enrolled students because they have either passed the course or they are old students, I don't need them, then I can uncheck it. And as soon as you see, you uncheck, you check it, there are some other things. And if you uncheck it, some other things like include comment, include their budget, include their role assignment, they also go away. See carefully on the screen, if I tick mark it, few more things they get tick marked. If I uncheck it, the other things also go. But I want all the activities and resources. I want all the blocks. I want all the files. I want all the filters, my calendar events, my question bank I want, if I made any group, yes. Competency, you know, the UGC has come up with that learning curriculum, learning outcomes based curriculum framework. So the competencies, you see here on the left, below the badge, the competencies are there. So you can define the competencies and it can take it. So, or if you want that, for you want to see further things, you can click on next. Otherwise, just simply click on jump the final step. And depending on the course, it will take time. And see, backup file has been created successfully. You continue. It will show you where it has saved your file. So here, this is the file which you have saved. And it will show you all your backup which you have taken. The name, it will show you it is a backup for this Moodle, for this course, the name of the course, and it adds the date like 23rd April 2020 in the way. That is actually computer style, year, month, and date we do it. And it shows you here the size and download or restore the course from where. So I will simply click on download from here. And it will, do you see the small window pop up on my screen? It is asking me to save this file. So I will click on save. It will ask me where to save this. And I will decide where the save file will go. And it will be saved in my hard disk. But let me do one more thing. Since you all are here, just very recently, I created a guide for my own faculty members just 2 days ago. You can see how to take a backup. So this is the instructions. Let me paste it into the chat box. It is here in the, and Dr. Sadhana can post it into the WhatsApp group also. You can download this presentation. I have made all these steps very clear in this guide, so that how you can take the backup of your course. Now the backup is ready with us. How we can go now to our Moodle course here. So here I am in my site administration, and it shows me that I have not registered. You can register. That's it's okay. I go to my courses, and you see here restore a course. There is no at present backup a course because there is nothing in my thing, but I will click on restore course. Now it is asking me that import. I need to bring that course from here. There are two ways. Either if something is there in this private backup area, I can take it from there, or now I need to shift that course which I took. So let me go back to my there, and where is my backup? That was Moodle. What was the name? I think I saved it. Okay, here I found it. Backup, I'm dropping it. I just used the drag and drop. I went to my folder, from there I brought it back. So now it has been added. I will click on restore. And if everything goes okay, it will tell me. So now there are various steps. It is the backup details, that it is a course. The format is the next version of Moodle. It is a general mode. There is the date taken, 3:35 p.m. I took it. The version which I used, now that is an issue which you may find. The Moodle Cloud which I am using is always the latest one, 3.8.1 and 3.8.2 as it is. But the version here may or may not be at present what the Moodle company actually is offering you. But then here it is showing you what are the course details, what has been added, what has been taken, and like that. And you click on continue. And then it is asking you the destination. Now this destination is very good for you. It is asking you, do you want to restore it as a new course or in another course which is something already existing? And you can select a category. So I can select a miscellaneous category, or I can create a new category and post it there, or you can add it to an existing course. So I don't have any existing course, but in that case it will add it here. So I'm going ahead with as a brand new course. And it includes enrollment methods? No, it doesn't. And say next. So this is the course setting. It is asking me, I can change the course name here.